Hello students, good morning. Take your history textbook and open the page number 26. National Policy on Education 1986. According to this policy, certain changes of a fundamental nature were brought about in primary, secondary and higher secondary education in keeping with the changing needs of the society. Under this policy, a common core curriculum was formed for all states. So, the National Policy on Education 1986. According to this policy, many changes brought about in our education system, especially in the primary, secondary and higher secondary education. Because the need of the society changed. According to the need of the society, the curriculum also how to change. Under this policy, a common core curriculum was framed for all state. A common set of courses decided for the all states of India, because all children in India need to get the same educational opportunity. So education system need to be modified to meet the needs of the society. For that, a common core curriculum was formed for the all the state, because all children in India need to get the same educational opportunity. Okay, so the scope of the national curriculum for individual state to bring in flexibility in accordance with their culture, geographical and historical needs. Each state can make some changes according to the according to their culture and their geographical and historical condition. But there must be a common core curriculum. Okay. Then according to this National Policy on Education 1986, in 1988, the primary education and curriculum was prepared. This prepared on the basis of the this policy, and it implemented the primary education curriculum implemented in 1988. And after that, a committee was formed at the national level with the Dr. R. H. Dave as its chairman. Under the chairmanship of Dr. R. H. Dave, one committee formed to determine minimum level of learning. This committee is formed to decide the minimum level of learning, and the Dave committee developed charts of minimum level of the learning in language, mathematics and environmental studies up to standard 5th. This was the decision by this committee to teach the language, mathematics and environmental studies up to 5th standard. Okay. Then use of satellite. In 1975, India met with success in the attempt, in its attempt to use a satellite for the purpose of education. In 1975, India started to use the satellite for the educational purpose. And Ignaz Chitnis, he was the scientist of ISRO. He played a very important role in this. In it means in the use of satellite in the for the educational purpose. And the satellite instructional television experiment was undertaken for the educational purpose under the leadership of Space Application Center at Ahmedabad. Under the leadership of Space Application Center at Ahmedabad, the site means satellite instructional television experiment undertaken. And the concept of satellite education came out for this experiment, and America helped India in this program. Means use of this satellite for the educational purpose, this experiment was undertaken, and America helped India in this program. And this program helped to make provision for good standard of education in rural area. Because of this, this project made available informational television program to rural area. Okay. Then Next is Indira Gandhi National Open University. This is, it is an open and distance learning institution, and it's not a like a regular college. It is open university. It is okay. The open university means it is for those who can afford to go to the college. They can do the distance study. Then this open university was established with the objective that the stream of education should make its way into every average household of the country. Okay, the stream of the education make available to every average citizen of India. The United Nations has declared 1970 as the International Education Year, and the same year, means in 1970, a seminar was organized in New Delhi on the subject of open university by the government of India Department of Education and Social Welfare, Information and Broadcasting Department, and the University Grant Commission along with the UNESCO. So in 1970 a seminar was organized in New Delhi. So by all this department, which are the department, Education and Social Welfare Department, Information and Broadcasting Department, then UGC and UNESCO. This all department were there to organize this meeting. And then in this meeting, the idea of establishing an open university evolved in this seminar. Okay, in this seminar also had the idea of starting an open university. Then in 1974, the government appointed a committee under the chairmanship of P. Pashuvarthi, and the open university took shape on 20th September 1985. Means after 10 years, 11 years, this open university took shape, means it is established. In accordance with the recommendation and the suggestion, it was named after Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. So the name of this university was University is Indira Gandhi National Open University. Then this university is for those who are unable to get a college education in the formal way, are given concession in eligibility criteria, age, and other coordination for admission to this university. It was an opportunity for those who had dropped out due to various reasons to continue their studies. And in 1990, they started an audio distance education program through Akashvani and Doordarshan. In 1990, they started audiovisual distance education through television, Doordarshan and Akashvani, and it conducted more than 1,000 curricula of various branches, and it has more than 1,000 set of courses, and it provided facilities for education through 58 training centers in the country and 41 centers in foreign country. This Indira Gandhi Open National Open University provide the training center. The 58 training centers are there in India, and 41 training centers are in foreign countries. So it's enough for today. Then tomorrow we are going to learn about the research institute, science institute. We will be studying in next class. Okay, thank you.